it's JQ Crafty. Welcome to my channel. Welcome to the Craft IQ Challenge. So, yes, I have a bunch of it done because I actually went live on Facebook during the beginning of the month when the first few prompts were released. So if you have not done the Craft IQ Challenge or been part of that yet, it is a Facebook group where every month there is a challenge. We are taking January off, but the challenge is you get 7 days of prompts or layers for a layer. It ends up being essentially a recipe challenge, but it's fun in a way, though. You can do it with a little twist. You can do it as the challenges, the layers come out, or the items in the recipe come out. And so you're scrapbooking daily for 7 days, just little bits at a time, and keeping a project in progress for those 7 days. So that is how you can do it, or you can just wait until you get all 7 prompts and then put your page together. Or you can do kind of a hybrid, like was what I kind of did. So I went live, and for some reason I was unable to like save my video. I don't know if that was a change with Facebook recently, but I wasn't able to do that for this month or last month. So it must have been a change they made. So unfortunately, I already have some of it done. And we're going to do this relatively real time because Mama hasn't had time to scrapbook, so I'm actually doing this the night before the hop. So, okay. So, first few prompts. Day one. Here, let me grab my little list here. Day one was create a paper piece background at least a third of the page. So I went ahead and I have a hexagon punch. It's one of those like punch anywhere punches. I think it was a Creative or what brand? We Are Memory Keepers. Yeah, Clear Cut Punch, which I might, there were a few on clearance in my Joann's. I might go grab some more because I don't mind them. But I went ahead and grabbed Brave and Bold. I grabbed the paper pad. That's what I got from Joann's also earlier this year. And I just picked random papers and punched a bunch of hexagons, blah, 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 and got those all plugged in. I popped my photos up on some foam. I just have 2 photos of my crazy son. And I backed it with, this is a Studio Calico paper from their Color Theory paper pad. And I grabbed some flair because that is, add circles was day 2 or layer 2. So I'm adding some flair. These are all, not all of them, I guess. Dottie About Flair and some, Yes Please Paper Crafts flair. Combination. Ooh, I'm gonna get my little flair stickers out. So I picked some of those out that I want to use, and I was gonna do kind of clusters somewhere. And then day 3 was 3+ colors. Well, I definitely have 3+ colors. Don't need to worry about that. So we need to add a border punch or fancy up an edge. That was day 4. We gotta do that yet. Add some ribbon or twine. We have to do that. Something shiny and some stars. Those are the things. So I grabbed some sequins that I wanted to maybe add on. These are Falling From You from Spiegelbank Scraps. They've been around forever, but I really liked the orange and the pink just to bring a little bit of that in. I have some stars. I have some acrylic stars from Color Cast Design, and I have these Bella Boulevard orange stars. I figured we could do a combination of those. I also grabbed a few titles from Color Cast Designs. I have this Fabulous, I have Outside Adventure, and then You're Fabulous also. So I wasn't sure which one I wanted to use there, so we'll play with that. I grabbed my trusty notebook edge because that's my favorite. So we're going to add a notebook edge behind these photos with some pattern paper, I think. And then I need to add twine. Do I have any tags? I don't know. We'll see about adding some stickers. Are there any tags in this ephemera? There's one. Because that would get me my twine. Did I already use it? That is the real question. So, yeah. I think, and I have some extra hexagons. I think we might. So, yeah, we're just going to finish putting the page together. Because a majority of it was done, like, during the live. Like, this was a big, so now it's really embellishment and adding some of the fun things in. Right? Right. So let's hit the road here. My desk is just a mess. It's always a mess though. I don't know why I can't keep it not a mess. But I think we're gonna add a little bit of a notebook edge. Bit of a notebook edge behind my photos. Might as well just cut a giant strip of it. Trimmer anymore. We should be able to finish up without that. Okay. Now the question is, where the heck did my scissors go? Been losing stuff all day. Seriously. Where's my scissors? Wait. And my edge distressor. Oh yeah, I was putting together Christmas cards. Okay. So I think we're gonna go here. And we're gonna go here. Fancy up an edge. There we go. Need to find out if I have that tag still. I guess if not, I think I have some plain tags I could use. Outlook not so good. Because I don't think it's in the here. No. Do not think I have the tag, but we'll see about any of this other stuff. Okay, let me go find a tag. I just want to tuck one behind here so I can have some twine. And I'll get right back to you. Okay, what I did off camera was I picked this out. I think I'm for sure going to use this, even though it's a different green, but it's going to stand out. I have these handy dandy scrapbook.com squares. They are perfect for flair. And then I decided just to kind of sprinkle them around instead of having them in clusters or anything. And so I added a sticker. I'm going to add some more ephemera and things, I think. Like, I was thinking about doing this one because he is totally one of a kind. And that's a good spot. Add some. Then I can journal over here. Let's see what else I've got on my sticker sheet. So let me look to see what I've got, and then I will be back with you in a minute. All right, I looked through the ephemera, I looked through the stickers. Nothing else jumped out of me that I wanted. So I plugged in a bunch of the stars. I grabbed a few sequins out of there. I glued them on. And I think we're gonna call it. I think it looks good. There's a lot of color going on anyway. So I'm not too worried about having clusters that are super noticeable. I have a few. That is fine. do what you need, right? Do what you need. So I think we're good. So I'm gonna go ahead and journal. Make sure you guys check out everybody else who is playing down below. Check out the Facebook group. Go ahead and play some of the challenges in January if you want to bust some stash, and keep your brain moving. Like I said, there will not be a new challenge in January at all, but we will be back in February. So we'll see you then. Thank you guys so much for watching. Appreciate y'all. And we'll see you next time.